Good morning, everybody, and welcome back to another weekly vlog. It's Monday, woo! I'm just gonna head to the gym right now, and then after I'm going to go grocery shopping, and later tonight I'm going to a Palm Bay event for The Bachelor. They're actually having a Bachelor viewing party, and it's really fun. I'm going with three of my friends, and I know a bunch of other people going too, so it's gonna be a good time, and I am excited, so excited. This is my outfit right now. I'm just going to the gym and then get groceries, so. My leggings are my Gymshark camo ones. I really wanted to get these in the green, but they sold out, so I'm like annoyed, but whatever. But these are like one of my favorite pairs of leggings besides my like Lululemons that I love. I'll have all my favorite stuff linked down below. Fitness apparel wise, I always link it in the bio if you guys want to shop it. Then this sweater is from Gymshark too, and my sports bra is Lululemon. I will have it linked down below. It's like a high neck one. I prefer the high neck ones. I don't know if I'm going to film this workout or not. I'll decide when I get there. I might not. I don't know. We'll see. All right, guys, I'm back. I thought I would do a little grocery haul of some stuff that I got. I'm not being as perfect with my diet, perfect in these quotations, because there is no perfect diet. Don't think you need to eat like me. Eat whatever makes you happy. I'm getting my test results back on Friday for what I'm intolerant to. So in the meantime, I've just kind of had this attitude where I'm like, I don't even know if I'm intolerant to anything, so I'm not gonna like restrict myself from eating things. But overall, I'm still eating really healthy. So I did get some maple nut instant oatmeal, some more coffee. I just got this brand. This is the one that I used to get in the K-cups, but I've been using the French press recently. So I got some more because I go through coffee so fast, it's insane. Some romaine lettuce, bananas, blueberries, strawberries, grapes. Then in my meat area, I got some tortellini to eat tonight just because it's really fast. Some bacon, salmon, chicken, more chicken. Some of these for when I'm lazy too, or like fish, breaded wild caught haddock. Yum. Then I just got some more bread, some, why did I forget what these are called? Pears. Wow, that took me a hot minute there. Some more of chips. I like just getting like the ones that have nothing artificial in them. I honestly think they taste better, like the salt and vinegar ones that are just like literally potatoes, vinegar, and salt. Like, I don't know why they have to add all this random shit into them. I got another duster because my room's getting dusty and I can't find the other one. I have no idea where it went. It's just missing in action. Gone. Don't know. I finally got onions. Oh my God, I kept forgetting to get onions and I've had to like cook without onions for like 2 weeks now and it's been horrible. I also got some garlic, a cucumber, some oat milk, a lighter for candles, a lint roller, because for some reason I'm like always covered in lint, even though I don't even live with dogs anymore. And then I got some more almond butter, and that is everything that I got. So guys, I'm about to head to the Palm Bay event, so I thought I would show you my, I know my Christmas tree is still up. You don't have to tell me. I know. I need to take it down. But this is my outfit. I'm just wearing this blazer. This crop top is from Princess Polly. Levi jeans, and I'm wearing platform Converse, and yeah, this is from, oh my God, I forget, Old Polly or something, or my memory is so bad, but yeah, this is my outfit, and I'll see y'all there.
She does not have a lot.
Good morning, everybody. This lighting is like really blue, which does not do me any favors, but good morning. Happy Tuesday. Exciting news, my dermatologist appointment got moved till today, which I am really happy about because before I was gonna have to wait till April, but it got moved because I had a cancellation. So thank you to the girl who canceled. I have no idea what the doctor is gonna recommend. My skin's actually doing a lot better right now because I do break out really bad before my period, and now I'm like past that. I'm into like the ovulation. I have like this app. If you guys are not on like a birth control kind of pill, you can get this app. This is not sponsored. I just use this app. It's called Flow, and it like is basically like a little thing where you can track your period and when you're ovulating. So currently for me, I'm in like the week pre-ovulation. So I did get 2 breakouts, but I break out really bad like the week before my period, and then it starts to get better. I only have like 2 cystic pimples and everything else is pretty flat, just kind of like a lot of scarring. So I don't know what she's gonna recommend. I don't know, but we'll find out and I'll let you guys know after my appointment. I'm just gonna put some concealer on underneath my eyes and mascara into my eyebrows so that I feel a little bit more put together. But obviously I'm not gonna cover up my breakouts because she got to look at those and decide what she thinks about my skin, because shit's go wild. This is like my new favorite under eye concealer, by the way. Where'd I put it? It's the Pat McGrath Labs Skin Fetish Sublime concealer. It's so good for underneath the eyes. The Bachelor last night was wild. Watching it at that event, I was like, this shit crazy. Okay, also, we got these t-shirts last night. Can I steal you for a second? Iconic. I love it. Thank you to Bombay for inviting me to that event. It was really fun. I got to go with like my close friends, and we just got to watch The Bachelor together and enjoy some Bombays, their new zero sugar ones that are coming out in the spring. But I don't know if Bombay is in America. I think it might be just a Canadian alcohol company. I don't know, but I want to do a little haul of some clothing pieces that I got from JWPEI, or it could be JWPEI. I'm just gonna say JWPEI, which is a website, and this is by the brand Simply Retro. So these are the pieces that I got. So first up, I got this really pretty like silk blouse with these little pearl buttons. These were all gifted to me, but this one is so cute. It's called the Mary Pearl Button Satin Blouse. It's so soft and I love the color of it. It's in this nice like burnt red color. Really, really pretty. I wanted some like nicer pieces. Just got two cardigans, the Anna Wool cardigan and the Olivia Wool cardigan. So what the first one is in this really nice green color. I love the color green, you guys know that. And it has these little like antique-y looking buttons. Super cute. Totally in right now. Cardigans are so in, and I love this one. I think it's so pretty, just the way that it's knit and it gets tighter. And then I just got this cream knit cardigan with these gold buttons that have like this really pretty detailing on them. It's so pretty. I love it. Then I just got this Camille sweater in this really pretty green color. It's like a turtleneck. It's got these really cool sleeves with this really cool cut detailing, and like there's just so many like little details on this that is so nice. It's in a really nice material and I'm obsessed. I'm gonna have links to all these items down below if you guys want to shop them. They're so nice, high quality, and I'm obsessed. They kind of have like a little bit more of like a dressy, vintagey look to them. I don't have anything in my wardrobe like this, so I love it. Hello everybody, happy Wednesday. So is it Wednesday? Yeah, Wednesday. I never updated you yesterday after my dermatologist appointment, so I would update you now. So she did put me on Accutane, but it's not called that anymore. It's like isotretinoin or something. Sorry if I'm saying that completely wrong. So she did put me on that. I went and did all my blood work yesterday and everything. So I'm actually starting it today. I don't know if it's different in the States, but she gave me the prescription for it. So I'm starting it today. I'm only starting on 10 milligrams. The most she said I can go to for my body weight is 40. So I can't even go up really that high anyway because I'm really small. So I'm only starting on 10 milligrams for the first month. I'm supposed to go get my prescription today. They didn't have it yesterday. I wanted to start yesterday, but they didn't have it, so they had to order it in for me. So fingers crossed I'll have it today so I can start, because I just want to start so the process can just go underway. Because I know that it's probably going to get worse before it gets better. She warned me about that too. So I kind of just want to get through the worst months as soon as I can so that it'll get better as soon as I can, if you know what I mean. So I put on my Instagram, you guys give me so many tips. If you guys have any tips and you've been on Accutane, you can comment down below. Let me know any tips and tricks for being on it. I will obviously be vlogging so you guys will see the process of what the hell happens to my face. I know it could get worse. So I'm just trying to tell myself that it's a process so that my mental health stays okay throughout this process, because I know that Accutane can be really hard on your mental health as well. I just want to make sure that I'm good and I'm Gucci and all that jazz. I've already started kind of like implementing a lot of things that I'm going to be doing while I'm on it today, because I'm going to take it for the first time today. So personally, the doctor told me I have to take 2000 IUs of vitamin D a day, because she said because I'm so small, it'll probably really deplete my vitamin D levels and that I need to make sure that they are high enough. So I have to take vitamin D. I also took it upon myself to start taking omega-3 because I heard that helps with the side effects of Accutane. And I've also started drinking a lot of water, using a lot of moisturizing skincare routine stuff. Exciting. So I'll up to you guys later. I think I'm gonna start taking it with my dinner, because I read that it's best to take it with like the biggest meal that you have, and dinner is probably the biggest meal that I have a day. So I'm gonna start off just taking it with my dinner. So yeah, I'll update you guys later, probably. Hello everybody, happy Thursday. I have a meeting downtown today, so I have to get ready in a bit. I thought I'd show you the skincare stuff that I have been, well, I've been using it for about 3 weeks now, basically. I hate when this lighting changes like this. I'm using it for like 3 weeks now because I've been like preparing myself because I thought the dermatologist would probably put me on Accutane just because I am scarring really badly. So, I guess I'll start with the morning. So in the morning, I literally just use the CeraVe Hydrating Cleanser. Then I go in with the CeraVe Moisturizing Cream. And then I have like two different sunscreens. I don't know, I'm just like torn which one I like better. I have the Illumiere MD Sheer Hydration Broad Spectrum SPF 40 and the SkinCeuticals Physical Fusion UV Defense SPF 50. They're both good. I don't know which one I prefer. At nighttime, if I'm wearing makeup, I take off my makeup with this. This is the Fresh Seaberry Skin Nutrition Cleansing Oil. It doesn't break me out. I saw it on, I think her name's Taylor Lynn. She had a whole series on Accutane and like being on it and stuff, and she used this, so I use that too. And then I'll wash my face with the CeraVe Hydrating Cleanser. To take off eye makeup, I just use Bioderma. And then at nighttime, I've started just using the CeraVe Skin Renewing Night Cream. And then I go over it with the Ordinary Rosehip Seed Oil. And I like it. It's supposed to be good for scars in like the long run. You have to use it for like a prolonged amount of time before you see any major bam, my skin looks so much better. And then I also put on the Lotus Youth Preserve Eye Cream from Fresh. And then on my lips, I just use the Aquaphor. That's what I'm doing for this whole process, hopefully. And we'll see what happens. I did notice I got a bunch of like little whiteheads this morning when I woke up, which I was like, okay, I don't think the medicine's working that fast. Okay guys, I'm all ready now to go downtown, but I'm gonna make myself a sandwich quickly to bring with me because it's like awkward timing. I don't wanna buy food down there. So I'm gonna make a sandwich and bring it to go with me. I'm gonna bring like this random bag that was from shopping because I wanna bring my water bottle too because I'm trying to drink a ton of water. I'm literally wearing all black and I'm just wearing my fuzzy like teddy coat over top of it to kind of like make it not as black, but it's an all black attire kind of day. I'm gonna make this sandwich now. It's the usual chicken, spinach, mayonnaise, mustard on some bread. Yay. I just finished up at my event. It wasn't really something that I was gonna vlog because it was kind of more like a meeting thing. They told us about all the new shoes at spring and whatnot, but I'm just walking now. I'm on Queen Street. I'm gonna walk for a bit. Probably catch an Uber halfway there because I don't want to walk the entire way, but thought I would get some steps in while I'm out here and it's not that cold and it's not raining or snowing. We might as well enjoy it. And I literally am never on Queen Street, so just enjoying. This is my outfit. Very casual. They gifted me a pair of shoes and a bag, which I'll show you guys when I get home. And I made this lipstick color that's on my lips right now, which is literally like the perfect, perfect nude. Like literally my lips feel better. I'm so into it. Love it. I really want to get a coffee too. So if I see a coffee shop, I will probably stop and get one. All right guys, I'm home now. I'm gonna go wash my face soon and then I chill for a bit before I make some dinner. I need to actually do an email, but I want to show you guys the lipstick color I made because it's literally like my perfect shade. I got it in the glossy or something finish. I used to like matte lipsticks, but I'm not really into them anymore. This is the shade. It's like my, I'll apply some. It's like my perfect nude shade. I'm obsessed. Literally like my dream color, all I've ever wanted in a lipstick. So thank you, Bite Beauty, for having me. And thank you to Spring for inviting me. I'll show you guys the shoes that I got because I didn't show them yet. They're like this new trend that's out now. They came in this really cute little bag that they gave us. I love reusable bags because I always have random shit with me. Whoa. Okay, so this is the bag they gave. Oh, it's so cute. It's like a little bucket bag in this like croc color. And then they gifted me a pair of these kind of like, this style is in now for sandals. What would you call this? Like a thong sandal with like a mini heel and it's in this really nice like denim. I'm gonna go wash off this makeup now, put on some comfy sweats, and then probably just chill out for a bit before I make my dinner. All right guys, so I'm making my dinner right now. I have like a big old salad and then I'm also cooking some salmon in the oven right now. And that's going to be my dinner. Yum. Really, really healthy, which is good. I'm trying to stay healthy as, oh my God, hiccups.
as healthy as possible to fight off this coronavirus that apparently is going around, because I'm like, not here for it. Not here for it. Just an absolute health freaking queen out here. Look at that. Healthy. Yes. Yum.
Good morning, everybody. I'll turn on the heat a bit. Good morning, everybody, and happy Saturday. I didn't vlog anything yesterday because I went to my doctor's appointment, my naturopath appointment, where they did all of my blood work for my hormones, food intolerances, and let me tell you, those results were freaking wild. I was like, holy shit. I'll share them with you in a bit because obviously I'm out right now, so I don't have the results and I don't really have them memorized. I can share my food intolerances, but I'll share my hormone results after because they're pretty bad. But my food intolerances, I took a picture of it just so that I would know. I mean, I'm mostly gonna avoid the moderate and severe food intolerances. So I had two severe ones and they're both so random. They were almonds and carrots. I eat almond milk and almond butter all the time. So I was like, oh my God, great. And then I have a bunch of moderates. So they are apricot, bay leaf, brewer's yeast, which is in beer, which I knew because beer always upsets my stomach the next day. Egg whites, egg yolks, avocados. So avocado toast is RIP for me. Black beans, which I knew. Grapes, did not know. I thought I liked grapes, apparently not. Sea bass, spinach, which I eat all the time, great. Sweet potato, again, thought that was good for me, apparently not. Well, for me personally, sweet potato. Watermelon, sardines, sesame seeds, string beans, and tomato. I'm not gluten intolerant at all, which is good. I can eat bread. I'm not intolerant to wheat at all. I am intolerant a bit to oats, but that was like in the mild, so I'm still gonna eat it. And coconut and stuff. There was a bunch that was in the mild section that we still gonna eat out here, because like, it's fine. I was most struck by almonds. That's wild. Almonds. All right, so we were at the mall, but change of plans. My dad's car broke down, so. Are we going to get him? Is that what we're doing?
Well, if CAA can drive him home, they will if they don't get another call. But if they get another call, they can't drive him home, so that's why we're leaving. Because we don't know.
My dad is stranded. His car always breaks down. It's just a piece of crap.
I guess I'm not spending any money today.
It's probably for the best anyway. We also found toilet paper. Thank God my Nana already hoarded toilet paper before everyone else started doing it. She's a trendsetter. She started the trend before everyone else. And so she has a shit ton of toilet paper. So she gave some to my mom. So my mom has toilet paper now. Woo! Never been so happy to have toilet paper, right? Literally.
I hugged it.
Yeah, that happy.
All right, so I thought I would show you guys my test results now that I'm back home. Basically, you want to be in like the green, which I am not. So this is my estrogen. It's really high. My progesterone is really low. My ratio PGET is low, which I don't know what that is. My testosterone is high, not ridiculously high, but high. My DHAs are normal-ish. My cortisol in the morning is high, then it's normal during the day, and then it's high at nighttime because I usually stress at nighttime, and that's why I can't sleep very well. But yes, this was very eye-opening to see. I was like, wow. That's great. So she did put me on a DIM supplement to lower my estrogen, and that should also help lower the testosterone as well in turn. Remember that you should see a doctor and do your own hormones before you just take pills for stuff. But which ones am I taking? This is the one that I'm taking for my progesterone and also anxiety. It's just P5P, which is an active B6 vitamin. And then for my estrogen, I'm taking 1,3-C-carbinol, which is an estrogen metabolism formula. And it's basically like a DIM supplement to help with that. And then I'm also deficient in iron. She did my blood test as well, and it came back that I have an iron deficiency and a zinc deficiency. So I'm taking an iron supplement and a zinc supplement as well. And then the other things I take is at nighttime, I take magnesium to help me sleep. That's my results. And then I showed you guys my food intolerances. But my hormones, I was like, holy crap, wild. Wasn't expecting that. Well, kind of was. I was expecting my testosterone to be high because acne. But yeah, my estrogen and progesterone is pretty bad. My testosterone is only a bit high, so I feel like that won't be that bad to fix. So we will see. But yeah, rough.